The U.S. Department of Justice is weighing in on a battle in Idaho over whether transgender athletes can compete in women's sports. The ACLU is suing the state over a new law that bans boys and men that identify as female from competing against females in public schools and colleges. The ACLU says the Idaho law discriminates and violates the 14th Amendment Equal Protection Clause. But on Friday, the Department of Justice said it supports the law. The Justice Department wrote, quote, "The Equal Protection Clause does not require states to abandon their efforts to provide biological women with equal opportunity to compete for and enjoy the lifelong benefits that flow from participation in school athletics in order to accommodate the team preference of transgender athletes." Athletes are also facing lots of challenges right now around COVID-19. The Fellowship of Christian Athletes is reaching out to students and coaches around the world who face a host of uncertainties about their sports in the next year. And now we are joined by Dan Britton, the FCA's chief field officer. Dan, thanks for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
Well, what are you hearing from your athletes and coaches? What are some of the obstacles they're facing during this pandemic?
Yeah, Wendy, since 1954, for the last 65 years, God has used FCA not only here in the U.S., but around the world in 92 different countries. So we work with 2 million coaches and athletes in every different age level. We say from 8 to 80, no matter what kind of athlete you are. But what we're experiencing is for the first time in our history that we're not allowed to do overnight camps. Last summer, we had 805 camps with 90,000 coaches and athletes that would have a week of inspiration and perspiration. And Wendy, we had to shift and realize that in the midst of this pandemic, we're talking about athletes' identity, understanding that, hey, your identity is not your sport, but your identity is Christ. You're going to be 100% athlete, 100% coach, based off of our theme, which is Mark 12:30, that love your Lord, your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and all your strength. And so we're seeing God do amazing things, allowing us to do virtual ministry, reaching coaches and athletes we'd never be able to reach before until this time.
So that you kind of answered my next question. So you are doing more virtual ministry right now. How does that work, you know, when normally, like you said, you had camps and everybody was out perspiring? How does that work virtually?
Yeah, not too much sweating anymore, at least on each other. But we find that what God is doing is we've always done a lot of virtual stuff. We've done partnered up with YouVersion with reading plans and devotions. We've connected with coaches and athletes in different training environments, Wendy. But what we realized is we moved our staff to the point of let's capitalize on this time for such a time as this to be able to gather. And so we actually did a coaches camp that normally we'd get 200 to 300 coaches at down the South. We had over 1,000 coaches and their spouses sign up for it. We had Tony Dungy speaking into them. We'd probably never have Tony be able to be available to come speak. And so we saw record numbers in our virtual camps as we stepped into that space to see what God would do.
And I love what you said earlier about, you know, building them up in their identity, not so much as athletes, but in who they are in Jesus Christ. And what has been the feedback from these young athletes?
Yeah, it's, you know, I think a lot of them are feeling a sense of loss, you know, like their season was taken away. Hey, the last season was taken away, their senior season. I have 3 kids, all played college lacrosse. My youngest was a senior at Liberty University. And you know, after 4 years and 14 years of playing the game of lacrosse, wow, his last season, he got his entire season taken away from him. And just to walk with him as a family to know what the loss is, and then as a ministry, Wendy, to be able to know that there is literally hundreds of thousands of athletes that are feeling the same sense, but to ground them back to God's word and to say that it's all about the relationship with Christ, that your identity is in Christ, your sport doesn't define you, Christ defines you, and what we get to do and glorify him is through our sport.
You know, I got chills when you were talking about your son, and I just really feel like, you know, God saw that sacrifice that all of these young people have made and older people. And do you believe, I mean, I believe in a God who can make that up, Ephesians 3:20, don't you?
Yes, I totally agree. I see that even though he had a sense of loss that he couldn't finish out his season that last year, we're already seeing how God's positioning him, and we're talking to other athletes that God is reconciling, that we're seeing redemption being done in this sense of loss, that God is positioning them for greatness.
Amen. Dan Britton with the Fellowship of Christian Athletes, thank you so much for being with us today. Enjoyed it.
Thank you.